In this video, following with the parts of the basics, we will see the systems. This is the model that we presented in the previous video. We have a transmitter with its antenna, the channel between the transmitter and the receiver, and the receiver. What we transmit is the signal. Now we will talk about the systems. What's a system? This is a very open question, but first we need to know what's a system. We need to deal with systems because the communications problem is modeled as a system problem. So with this point of view, we can see how the internal components of these systems interact with each other. The canonical definition of system is that is a set of interacting component parts that form a complex whole, and it's delineated by its boundaries. This is the definition by the Wikipedia. But what does this really mean? This means that when dealing with something complicated, you divide this problem into pieces and see how these pieces interact with each other. And also, you need to know, of course, the input and the outputs from this system. So, for example, if we consider two people talking as a system, we need to know that there will be a transmitter, the person who is talking, a receiver, the person who is listening at that moment, and also these two persons are interchanging something. This something, you can say from a physical point of view that they exchange pressure waves, or from a higher level you can say that they exchange words. This is the communication systems. Here we can see that we have five subsystems or five components. The first one, this one here, it's the source of the information. For example, it could be a person talking, or a file that we want to transmit, or a video, or something else. Here, the second step, the second subsystem, is the transmitter. This is all the hardware, all the software that is involved in the transmission of the signal. As I said before, between the transmitter and the receiver, there is the channel. Here, there are a lot of possible or potential perturbations, noise, interference, distortion, and so on. The next step, as I said before, is the receiver. These three parts, the transmitter, the channel, and the receiver, are the transmission system, what we call the transmission system. And finally, is the destination. This destination could be a person watching the TV, or a person listening to other person talking, or maybe a PC or another computer, and so on. This is the complete communication system. Here, every block involved in the communication process is depicted. You can see that it's the same approach as before, but with more detail. We have an analog source, a digital source, the source coding, the ciphering, if you want to encrypt your signal, the channel coding, the multiplex, and so on. All these parts in the transmitter here have their counterpart in the receiver down here. And as we say always, the channel is between the transmitter and the receiver. In future videos, we will see in detail each one of these boxes. This is the simplified model. This is the model which we will work with in this course. In the transmitter part, in the upper part of the diagram, you have an input, which is the data. The first subsystem is the modulator, the encoder, and so on. The second part is the interpolation filter. The third one is the digital mixer with an oscillator. Here we will change the frequency of the signal. The fourth part is the converter from digital to analog. And finally, the radio frequency front end, and always the antenna. This is the scheme of the general architecture of a transmitter. In the receiver, it's more or less the same. We have the antenna, then the radio frequency front end, the analog to digital converter, because what we transmit is an analog signal, a digital mixer with an oscillator to change the frequency of the signal from radio frequency to intermediate or to baseband, and a low pass filter, a decimation stage, and also the demodulator, and so on. And finally, we obtain the data that we had. This is a very important concept here. It's the black box concept. This means that you consider a system or a component as only the relationship between the outputs and the inputs. So it does not matter what happens inside that box. You don't need to know the details about that box. You only need to know from the output that goes from a certain input. That's it. Thank you for your attention.